Hello, multi-militant, modish, malt monsters, and thank you to... I've already said that one in my last review. This is why I should put a line through the malt mentions, once I have mentioned them. I'm not even going to edit that one out. It's a blooper. Hey, bloopers happen. Let's start again. Hello, malty monkey malt shoulders, and thank you to Darragh McAvoy for that malt mention introducing 879 extras review in the bothy. I'm Ralfy, little Ralfy, brother of Big Clive, and he's been going bonkers with his water purifier because he loves his gadgets and he does a lot of gadgety things in his channel. But because it's dealing with alcohol, he's passed over his experiment to my channel so as that the malt mates can get to know about it. And some of Clive's regular subscribers and viewers can get to see what the whiskey connoisseur makes of it. A connoisseur. I never call myself a connoisseur. I call myself an enthusiast. So, he got a bottle of Merlot. Here it is, Yellowtail Merlot from Australia. And he bought the bottle purely because of the label, because he thought the label looked attractive. So he went into the supermarket, looked at all the bottles of red wine up on the shelf, and he specifically picked this one, not to do with the price, not to do with the region, not to do with the country, just because he liked the orange and white. And then he put it through a water purifier, and this is what he got. As clear as water. I'll hold up to my little focal thing so you can see how clear it is. That was red wine. And then what he did was he got all the syrup at the bottom of the water purifier, and he reconstituted it with vodka, supermarket vodka, which he then had before he did, so he diluted it down to the strength of the wine, which is, in this case, let me see, probably about 12%. They usually are. 13.5%. So I pour a wee glass of that. Before I go any further, just so as you know, I put the rectified wine into the fridge because when I first tasted it at room temperature, it wasn't that pleasant. It needs to be chilled like a white wine. Just sharing. A soft, dilute red wine nose. The typical fruit notes that you would expect. A little bit of cherries, blackcurrant you'd expect from a Merlot. It's on the nose, but it's almost as if it's been turned into an anemic eau de vie, which it really has. It starts off slightly anemic, like almost like it's a very soft rosé, but then it starts to go slightly dry and cardboardy in the development in the palate, and the finish is absolutely negligible, and it's totally forgettable and a complete non-event. So don't waste your wine. The reconstitution with the vodka, hey, it's neutral alcohol, so you know it's good for a shot. You're not getting the nose that you got from the original wine. It's, to put it politely, neutral. Acidity. Tannins. This is what's happened with the water rectifier. It's left some of the more delicate flavours in the rectification. They've come across in the rectification, but it's left behind in the water purifier. It's left the heavier notes, the molecularly heavier notes that you would get in a red wine, which are the tannins. As you can see, it's not clear. The colour and a sort of vague cherry note and a sweetness. The tannins certainly are quite prominent. All in all, in my opinion, the whole thing's a complete waste of time. It's just a novelty. You might try it once and that's it. But hey, I'm not going to recommend it. I think it's just a waste of a bottle of wine to do that, actually. And there you have it. It's my opinion. Just sharing. Bye-bye. Think about my clicker's not worked. Clivey made me this clicker. It's a stop button. Stops the thing recording. And I pressed it and it didn't work. This is punishment, by the way, for giving his experiments bad reviews. Try again.